your brother, may, baka tinitingnan niya na ginagamit mo si Simpson na dummy because a Canadian citizen ka, dual ka nga, yung paggamit mo sa kanya, delikado ka kay Simpson.
Yung bumili ng bahay ko, sir, gusto niyang umalis yung kapatid ko doon sa bahay ko para ibigin na niya yung pera ko. Tulungan mo po ako na mapalis yung kapatid ko para makuha ko na yung pera ko.
I think they have a problem with relational.
Yes,
the other thing is legal.
Yes,
now, this
sir.
Is your brother. Kapatid mo to.
Yes, sir.
Medyo yung relasyon mo sa kapatid mo strained. Seems na hindi kayo close. May legal din akong nakikita na ina-apply niya rito. Ikaw ba'y Canadian citizen?
I'm a dual citizen, sir.
So
a
dual
Filipino.
Citizen. Okay, that's fine. But you live in Canada?
Yes, sir.
All right. You pay your taxes sa Canada or sa Pilipinas?
In Canada, I pay my taxes.
That's where you pay your taxes.
Because I have my business there.
Okay. That's why I ask you, where you pay your taxes, but basically dual ka, but considered Canadian citizen ka pa rin because you are now obligated to pay your tax sa Canada.
Yes, sir.
And you have, you know, by virtue of being a Filipino.
Yes, sir.
Then, na ano ka, nagkaing Canadian citizen ka, kaya nabinigyan ka ng dual.
Yes,
okay?
Sir.
So, kanino nakatitulo ang bahay sa Pangasinan? Kanino nakapangalan? Sa
Lailani iyo? Simpson, sir.
Sino si Lailani Simpson?
Yung binilhan ko ng bahay.
So si Lailani Simpson, nandyan pa ang title sa kanya?
Yes, sir.
Do you have an absolute deed of sale sa papel na nagsasabi may transaction na binili mo, kaya for time being, meron kayong arrangement na sa kanya muna nakapangalan because this is the complication?
Yes, sir.
Your brother, may, baka tinitingnan niya na ginagamit mo si Simpson na dummy because a Canadian citizen ka, dual ka nga, kasi yung paggamit mo sa kanya, nakatitle pa rin sa kanya, delikado ka kay Simpson. Baka kasi ang problema mo hindi sa kapatid mo. Baka magiging problema mo si Simpson at pagkatapos ang kapatid mo si Simpson may ugnayan. Baka sila ngayon nag-uugnay na parang pahihirapan ka. And baka dahil nakikita naman ni Simpson na ang kapatid mo, mas kinikilala niya kasi ikaw laging wala. Although ikaw bumili, so must be favor siya doon sa kapatid mo. You talk to Simpson and make sure that there's a letter and the title, si Simpson pa rin nagmamayari.
Yes.
I-demand mo silang paalisin, they will not because unless they see si Simpson ang magpapaalis, hindi ikaw. Si Simpson ang dapat maglagay ng letter and must stand for you. I am the owner of the property. I demand that you leave. Now, there will be complication. Paano nakatira sa bahay ito na hindi alam ni Simpson na ngayon pinalalayas niya? You can't because you have to give them due process, time na para mag-relocate. Yeah. This is where the complication is.
Yes.
Your attorney will just simply write a demand letter. But your brothers, your siblings will not honor it because they know that the name and the title of the property is not under you. It's under Simpson. You have to change the title of the property.
Oh, okay, sir.
You got to tell your lawyer to transfer it to you. Have it transferred to your name first.
Transfer to my name?
No, when you transfer it to your name, another owner, you're still going to be dealing with your siblings. Then if it's transferred to you, it doesn't save you from the headache where your siblings were still not going to go out of the property and you cannot drive them away because they will have to assert the right. You are my sister. We can't find a place where we can go. You need to pay us. Or you find a place where we could be relocated, but you also have to compensate us. That's the law. Absolute deed of sale. You bought the property. It has to be transferred to your name. We have to settle that. You have to go to your attorney. Facilitate the absolute deed of sale. Transfer the title to your name. Take care of that. And then that's number one. Now, since you own the property now, you can now take action by probably notifying this person that they should vacate the place, but there are legal implications again. You have to compensate them. You have to look for some other place that they could, you know, be relocated to. No kicking. I want you to take possession of the title of the property because you already have the absolute deed of sale, as you said.
Yes, sir.
Facilitate the transfer of the title to your name. because you have an absolute deed of sale. Mm-hmm. Once it's under your name, so you have to hire the services of a broker in the real estate to make sure it's been transferred to you. Mm-hmm. Legally, it's transferred to you now. Make sure that there's no annotation or notes that says you can't move because you owe them blah blah blah. Mm-hmm. You better go ahead and hire a broker so the broker can look at whatever's in the Land Registration Authority, LRA.
Yes, sir.
What you can do is the deed of donation, donate it to your brother. If you drive them away, what are you doing? Focus on this. Who are these people?
That's my brother and the children. They live all in my house.
Give it to them because you know what? Your life is better in Canada. You are well off. Your poor siblings here, I don't know exactly what kind of life they have. Can't you see? They're not well off. They're relying on you. Do you want, one, miserable, two, peaceful and tranquil life? Which one? One or two?
Of course the peaceful
one. Two. It will only happen if you give this piece of property to your, you know, brother. It's just talk to your siblings equally. Just donate it to them.
Hi. I'm Joanne DePau and I'm 10 years old. Have you already subscribed to BTAG official YouTube TV? Like me, my parents, and millennials, we watch BTAG videos. Subscribe now. See ya.